Welcome to RAF Scampton, the home of the Royal Air Force Aerobatics Team, better known as the Red Arrows.
The good movies are in three parts. Often the best is saved till last. We're here to celebrate today the third in a trilogy.
This journey starts with us announcing the Red Arrow editions in April. It continues today, and hopefully it will go on for years to come. And the customers of these cars, I assure you that you really are buying a very special part of our history.
The idea for this project really is the ultimate expression of the Aston Martin Cambridge Aviation series of cars, and that project started off in 2015 with the V8 Vantage S Blades Edition. And they're a team of former Red Arrows pilots. We built five cars with them, and that was a relatively simple project because they're a private team, and they also delivered the handover event with the five aeroplanes flying over the cars. And right from the outset of that project all those years ago, I had an ambition to do the same thing with the Red Arrows.
I'm extremely honoured to be invited here and to play just a small part in the handover of these beautiful cars. I've been in the car industry for 38 years. Believe me, I've handed over an awful lot of cars to an awful lot of people, and I've never seen anything quite like this. So well done for everybody for pulling it together.
The door was open to this project with the V12 Vantage S Spitfire and our relationship with the Royal Air Force Benevolent Fund. That project, we delivered a donation of £40,000 to the RAF Benevolent Fund from V12 Vantage S Spitfire, and I started to think about how we could go a stage further with that, and that if we built 10 cars with the Red Arrows team, then perhaps we could donate the 10th car to the RAF Benevolent Fund, and perhaps that would unlock the door to the RAF and the Red Arrows. And I felt it was really important that if we're doing a project with the Red Arrows, that we give something back to the very brave men and women who've served in the Royal Air Force. And the Royal Air Force Benevolent Fund is a fantastic charity, does amazing things, and I've met many of the servicemen and women who've benefited from the charity's work. So it was absolutely very important to involve them in this project. The other decision that we made was rather than to auction the 10th car, that we would raffle a car and thereby give anyone with a £20 note the chance to win this amazing car.
This is an amazingly important project for us, the RAF Benevolent Fund. With the money we raise in this initiative, which is absolutely outstanding, and coming together of the Aston Martin brand with the Red Arrows and the Royal Air Force Benevolent Fund, you know, three great British brands all rolled into one.
The RAF Benevolent Fund has helped me in massive ways over the years with my transition to the civilian world, and I'm just one of many people. You know, this project that's going on now can have a massive impact on their lives.
Amongst the whole experience that you get today, from motoring to aviation, something you definitely will get is an insight into a Royal Air Force squadron.
It's a fantastic opportunity for us to join together with a fantastic project put together by Aston Martin to raise as much money as we can for the Royal Air Force Benevolent Fund, a fantastic charity that goes and changes the lives of so many people that really do need it.
It's a real privilege for me to be here and to see how all this has finally come together after what I know has been many months, indeed years of hard work and preparation.
This partnership sees Aston Martin extend our long-held association with the RAF. Our headquarters, of course at Gaydon, was built on a former RAF base, and we're at this very moment converting a set of RAF super hangars in St Athens, Wales, into a world-class manufacturing facility.
I've been involved in the design of the car from the very early days when we first went up to RAF Scampton in the middle of winter in a very cold January, and spent the day with the team looking at their jets to pull ideas that we could put into this car. And yeah, some of the ideas that were in the car were my idea. Some of the ideas came from the team. So it's really great to see some of the things that I suggested now actually on this car.
The most fulfilling aspect, aside from our primary role of representing the men and women of the Royal Air Force, is really representing this, the creativity, innovation of UK design and technology.
Working on the Red Arrows car has been a really exciting and challenging project to work on. The most fun feature to create on the car has definitely been the helmet pods in the rear. The challenging element of that is to be able to package the helmets in a safe environment which are going to be retained, and also to be presented and to look fantastic when the customers are driving along in the car. the most complex item of the car, feature of the car, is by no doubt the roof. Putting the foil and floating it into the lacquer was a huge challenge for all of the team, but we've managed to pull it off. I think it looks fantastic, and it's definitely something that shines on the car. It's always a wonder for all our customers as to how we did that. My favourite personal bit of the car has to be all the formations throughout the car. The champagne split running down the centre of the car, the jets appearing out of panels. It's definitely a feature which just pulls all the car together. And using the stitch, the traditional stitch from automotive design and interior design, and linking that element over to the jets is just, it's amazing. Seeing the final car come together is always a great wonder. You're bringing all these small features together and putting them into one car, one piece of art, one collector's piece. It's finally putting that final fingerprint of that touch of Q onto that specific Vanquish S.
When we paint our cars, we paint every component at the same time. So here you can see obviously the boot lid, you've got the body, the bumpers, the light infills. Everything is painted at the same time.
Editions are really a further example of the level of personalisation that our Q Commission team is able to deliver.
We've got what's called the champagne split embroidery, which comes from the front cubby lids, over the armrest, into the cup holder, would you believe, out the back of the tunnel and over to the rear parcel shelf. So this is to mimic a flying formation, as if you would look in the sky when the Red Arrows are doing one of their formations. We also have the Diamond 9 formation in each of the front seat headrests. So on the driver's side, your particular plane will be picked out in red. That will obviously move around the formation depending on which car you are. And then on the passenger side, it'll be picked out in blue, as if you're an engineer. When we build a car, we have very few areas of the car which are effectively a blank canvas for us to use. And how many people in this room get in their car and just look forward? They never look up. But if you look, when next time you go to your car and you look up, effectively your headlining is always bare. There's nothing there. It's just a piece of fabric, a piece of leather, a piece of material. It doesn't do anything. We have a great space to do something with. When you're looking up from inside the car, you'll see this. So what we want you to do is sit in the car, look up and think that someone, A, someone's stolen your roof, B, you've actually inadvertently got into an aircraft, C, where is my car?
My favourite part of the car is the switchgear. The fact that they've used part of the landing gear and melted it down and cast the switchgear themselves is an ingenious idea. And to have part of the aeroplane in the car is a wonderful touch.
Each of your cars have been expertly and most importantly handcrafted by our team in Gaydon. I think they're a unique piece of history.
My final words are to those proud new owners of these cars. Your support, your recognition through buying these cars, your recognition of the Red Arrows, Aston Martin, the Royal Air Force, the connections which are made between them. And I hope that you feel that we are recognising what you have done in an appropriate way, demonstrating, as I say, the best about the Royal Air Force, the best about Aston Martin, and the best about the United Kingdom.
It's fantastic to have you here today, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the events that are planned for you.
I'd like personally to thank Simon Lane and the team at Aston Martin Cambridge. They are exemplary as dealers in the Aston Martin network. They push our Q team to the limits, and they curate a customer experience which is second to none in the world. So thank you for that.
It's been 18 months in the making from when we first approached the Red Arrows team to a finished car sitting behind me, and that's been an amazing journey. To bring Aston Martin and the Red Arrows together has been a dream come true.